Ellis, Cineplex reporting third quarter earnings recently. Words such as turned a corner were used on the call. How important are those Q3 numbers? What does the story tell you?
It looks like we have turned the corner and our guests are really eager to come back to the cinemas. We saw some great attendance once we were reopened across the country, which happened in the middle of July. And we had some great movies that played through and that went through all the way through till September. And then in October, we also had another great month with some large titles.
The box office numbers were up, as you had just mentioned. Attendance was up at around 8.3 million in Q3. It's still less than half of what you saw at that same time in 2019. How do you think about that story?
What we see, though, is you have to remember in July, we had just reopened on the 17th. And so July was handicapped by the fact that it was, a less number of days compared to 2019. But as you look through each and every month of the quarter, it got stronger. And actually, in October, as I said on the call, we were 80% of 2019, which to me is, getting towards the right numbers as we move forward.
How long do you think it'll take for you to get there to where you were?
Well, it's exciting. This past weekend, we actually had our biggest weekend since, the start of the pandemic. And there were certain weekends, like when we opened Shang-Chi, we had the biggest weekend for that particular weekend, Labor Day, ever. So there are signs of, our guests wanting to come back and indulge in that great, spectacle that you get when you're in the movie theater.
When you think about the future, the trajectory of your business, streaming options have seemed to kind of take over that space. And I guess as movies get out there a lot quicker now, it's giving audiences that other option. How do you see your model changing or shifting?
Well, we were thinking about this many years ago, and we actually created the Cineplex store where you can participate and do a PVOD purchase. And for example, the Bond movie just came out 2 days ago on PVOD, and it's also playing in our theaters. But on PVOD, you've got to write or pay a $25 or $24.99 to watch the movie, on a small screen with all the distractions that you get at home compared to going into one of the big formats in our theaters across the country. So it's a different experience. Like I saw Bond in our theater, and it's a totally different experience than watching it on a small screen. You don't get the same attributes that you see. And we've made so many improvements to the theater experience, from Ultra AVXs to IMAXs to VIPs to all of those different opportunities to enjoy and participate in a way you cannot replicate at home.
Ellis, more importantly, you don't get that movie style popcorn.
That is for sure. And we have seen our guests love that. And we, started the Uber Eats and Skip the Dishes, where you can order your goodies and have it delivered to your home, and you can watch the movie on the Cineplex store, especially when the theaters were closed for such a long period of time.
That's right. But when you think about challenges on the horizon, of course, as Cineplex has expressed in their earnings call, suggested that they are anticipating a judgment with respect to the Cineworld case in the next several months. So we can't get into that. But when you think about obstacles on the horizon, inflation seems to be a big word making headlines these days. Is that something that you're concerned about? I mean, Cineplex had mentioned that you have some room there, but how much room do you have before you pass on those costs to the audience?
We continue to review our situation, and to me, the more important is the supply chain and making sure that we have the products we need for our guests when they come to the theater. And we will, you know, monitor how inflation is, in what direction it's moving, and, you know, decide whether we need to pass and what amounts we would pass on to our guests. Because our whole focus now is to bring our guests back to the theaters, our Scene members, our CineClub members, to enjoy the experience.
We are headed into the holiday season. Christmas Day, a big day at the box office, some Oscar contenders also being rolled out in movies at this time. How big is this season for you?
Well, I mean, we've had a lot of strong movies over the last number of weeks. We had both the movie Dune and also the Bond movie, which No Time to Die, which has done really well for us. You've got Ghostbusters coming into the theaters. You've got House of Gucci, got West Side Story. You've got Spider-Man. You've got The Matrix. So there's a lot of film, you know, for the next 7 weeks as we get towards the end of the year. And we're excited about the fact that the product is also differentiated. It's not all big blockbusters. It's included, you know, movies like The House of Gucci and West Side Story, which should bring out, you know, the groups of individuals that have been afraid to come back to the theater.
Ellis, what trends do you see coming down the pike?
I see there's going to be more content being made, both for the movie theaters and from the streamers, and then studios that have the, you know, different ways of capturing the audiences. And I think we have to work together with our partners to figure out how do we maximize the value for both of us from that guest that's coming through our doors. And we've also, you know, diversified quite a bit in Canada with our, you know, rec rooms that we have and palladiums, and then our media and digital media businesses, and our Player One Amusement Group, which basically gives us, you know, different sources of revenue. And we've created what I call an entertainment destination for Canadians across the country.
During the pandemic, Cineplex had suggested that assets such as real estate could potentially be sold to cover off debt. Where do you stand with that now? Is that still on the table?
Well, we you know, did a couple of things where we sold our head office and did a lease back to generate some cash to keep us going when the pandemic was at its highest level. And we continue to look at opportunities right across the country as to what we should be doing and focusing on. Because for us, the importance is to get the business back and be strong as we were prior to the pandemic.